Good morning, dear students. Today we are discuss the remaining part of the foreign exchange. So guys, now today we are discuss the fixed exchange rate. What is fixed exchange rate, guys? The rate of exchange fixed by the government on the behalf of the gold, we can say that is the meaning of fixed exchange rate. Clear beta? What is fixed exchange rate? The rate of exchange fixed by the government with the help of gold is called fixed exchange rate. Clear? It is also called mint parthyo. Guys, we have two types of fixed exchange rate. The first one is golden system and next one is platinum system. It is also called adjustable pegged theory. First of all, we are discuss golden system. So under golden system, guys, we know that when the two countries gold purchasing power equal with each other, then government decided the rate of exchange. Clear? Two countries currency gold purchasing power equal with each other, then the government fix the foreign exchange rate. For example, the $1 purchase 5 grain gold, and the same as Indian 60 rupees purchase 5 grain gold. So the both countries gold purchasing power equal with each other. So the exchange rate $1 is equal to 60 rupees. Clear? Next one, Bretton Woods system. Guys, it is also called adjustable pegged system. According to this system, in fixed exchange rate, adjustment is possible according to IMF rule and regulation. When the all currency pegged with the dollar and the dollar value ultimately measures in gold, dollar value measures in gold. So ultimately all currency value measures in gold, then adjustment is possible in fixed exchange rate according to IMF rule and regulation. Clear beta? So guys, the Bretton Woods system is also abandoned in 1977 and it is also replaced in the flexible exchange rate. Now we discuss the difference between fixed exchange system or flexible exchange system. So the fixed exchange system, it is determined by the government. The flexible exchange system determined by the market force, like demand of foreign currencies and supply of foreign currencies. Fixed exchange system change according to plan, but the flexible exchange system do not change according to plan. It is always change according to market force. Fixed exchange rate determined always by the government. The flexible exchange system determined by always market force. Government, in fixed exchange system, government required more stock of foreign currencies. In flexible exchange system, do not require more stock of foreign currencies. In fixed exchange system, the degree of speculation is very low. But in flexible exchange system, the degree of speculation is very high. That's your difference between fixed exchange system or flexible exchange system. Now we are discuss managed floating. What is managed floating, guys? We know that when in fixed exchange rate, adjustment is possible according to IMF rule and regulation, we can say that is managed floating. Clear? Managed floating. In fixed exchange rate, adjustment is possible according to IMF rule and regulation is called managed floating. Next one, dirty floating. Guys, we know that when in exchange rate adjustment is possible without any rule and regulation, we can say that is dirty floating. Clear, beta? Man is floating. In exchange rate adjustment is possible according to IMF rule and regulation is called balance floating. Dirty floating. In exchange rate adjustment do not possible according to IMF rule and regulation, that is called dirty floating. Clear? Next, we have discussed the source of demand of foreign currencies. Why we need the demand of foreign currencies? So we have the lot of sources for the demand of foreign currencies. The first one is repayment of international loan. If we take loan from international market, so at the time of repayment, we have the requirement of lot of foreign currencies. So that's your first sources of demand of foreign currency. Next one, investment in the rest of the world sector. If we want to invest the huge amount in international market, international country, then we have the requirement of lot of foreign currencies. Next one, import. When we purchase some goods, some machine, some technology from abroad, then we have the requirement of foreign currency for the payment of import. Next one, direct purchasing from abroad. When we direct purchase some goods and services from abroad, then we have the requirement of foreign currency. Grant and donation to abroad. If we give to grant and donation to rest of the world country, then we have the requirement of foreign currencies. Or factor payment to rest of the world sector. When the some foreigner provided service in domestic territory, then we have the requirement of foreign currencies for the payment of its service. So that's your source of demand of foreign currencies. Next one, the source of supply of foreign currencies. So we have a lot of source of supply of foreign currencies. The first one is export. When we export some goods and services to rest of the world sector, then we receive some foreign currencies. That's your source of supply of foreign currency. Next one, investment from rest of the world sector. When we invest, when we receive some investment from abroad, then we receive the foreign currencies. That's your another source of supply of foreign currency. Direct purchasing by rest of the world sector. When the some foreigners directly purchase some goods and services from domestic market, then we receive the foreign currencies from foreign. Loan from rest of the world sector, that's your another source is the supply of foreign currency. When we receive some loan from another country, then we receive the foreign currencies. Grant and donation received from another countries, then that is the another source of the supply of foreign currencies, because the all grant and donations received from the abroad in foreign currencies. Factor income received from abroad, that's about another sources of the supply of foreign currency. Remittance by the NRI. The sum NRIs is remittance from abroad, then the all the payment will come in foreign currencies in domestic territory. That's your source of supply of foreign currencies. Now we are discussing the foreign exchange market. The market where deal the international securities, we can see that is the meaning of foreign currency. Foreign exchange market. Or you can say the market where deal the securities, exchange the securities, then we can say that is foreign exchange market. The function of foreign exchange market. The foreign exchange market perform three functions. The first one is transfer function, credit function, or hedging function. Next one, operation of foreign exchange market. The foreign exchange market is operate two types, the spot market, or next one is forward market.
Spot market, the whole transaction done on the spot, and the forward market, the transaction is done near future. Next one, how can you say the foreign exchange and the demand of foreign currency both have a negative relation? Guys, we know that the foreign exchange, forex and demand of foreign currencies both have a negative relation, because at the moment the demand of foreign currency is greater than the supply of foreign currency, and the domestic currency is depreciate. And if the domestic currency is depreciate, like $1 equal to 60 rupees, then after depreciation we paid $1 is equal to like 80 rupees. So Indian currency is like domestic currency is depreciate. At the moment the exports will be rise and imports will be fall. When import will be fall, then we have the requirement of less amount of foreign currencies due to rise the forex. So here is the forex and demand of foreign currency both shows negative relation. The next one, how can you say the foreign exchange and supply of foreign currencies both have a positive relation? So we know that, guys, when the foreign exchange rise, then the demand of foreign currency is greater than the supply of foreign currencies. At the moment the domestic currencies depreciate, and exports will be rise and imports will be fall. Due to rise the exports, the receiving of foreign currencies more due to rise the forex. So it shows the forex and supply of foreign currencies both have a positive relation. Clear? When the forex rise, the demand of foreign currency greater than supply of foreign currency, so domestic currencies depreciate, exports increase, import fall. Due to rise the exports, the supply of foreign currencies rise due to rise the forex. Clear? That's your operation of foreign exchange market. Clear, beta? So that's your chapter is finished. So you have a lot of questions, and you can prepare on your fair copies. What is fixed exchange rate? Briefly explain the golden system. Briefly explain Bretton Woods system. What is balance floating? What is dirty floating? Explain foreign exchange and demand of foreign currencies have a negative relation. Explain foreign exchange or supply of foreign currencies both have a positive relation. Clear? Now we are discuss what is revaluation. When the domestic currency's values rise by the government is called revaluation. Explain devaluation. The value of domestic currency is reduced by the government is called devaluation. Clear, beta? What is foreign exchange market? Explain its function. What is spot market? What is forward market? All question you will prepare on your fair copies. If you have in this chapter any doubt, then you can contact me. You can take all the doubts immediately. Clear, beta? Thank you very much.